This is not a sponsored video. I have been using Setapp for more than a year now, and I'm freaking loving it. So today, I'm going to show you 10 of my favorite apps from their extensive library. Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and if you do like this type of content, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and let's dive in. So let me share with you the top 10 apps I cannot live without on my Mac. So, all of these are a part of Setapp, so if you're interested on getting 1 month free on Setapp, go ahead and take a look at this video till the end for the details. So, the first one is ADGUARD. So, what is ADGUARD? Well, it is a tracker blocker and an ads blocker. So, for example, if you go to my site and you do have the Safari extension installed there, you can take a look at it. You can enable or disable ADGUARD on particular sites or particular pages on the site. And yeah, it's a really, really good refresher, and it's working flawlessly on all sites. I use it quite a lot, so I don't get those annoying ads. So yeah, that's really what it does. It is blocking tracking and ads. So let's take a look at the second one, which is I have been using quite a lot, and that is Bartender. So as you can see on my like navigation bar right over here, like the menu bar right on top, you can see I don't have that clutter that usually goes in there. But if I hover there, you see all of my apps pop up, and I can select any of them. But if I hover away, I don't have that clutter. So yeah, that is what Bartender does. And it has a lot of tweaking stuff, like you can have this really, really cool eyeglasses there, or you can have three dots, whatever you choose to, or even your own glyph, like image there added. Okay, so that is Bartender, a really, really cool app that I'm using frequently, so it does not clutter my screen. So let's go back and let's see, take a look at the third one on the list, and that is CAPTO. Now, CAPTO is the app that I'm recording this video right now. And if you can also take screenshots and all of that good stuff, but with CAPTO, you can basically capture your screen and then export it. So yeah, you can later use it. And you can capture a fraction of your screen or your home screen, or you can even capture one app that you want. So it's a really, really versatile screen recording tool. So that is CAPTO. Now, next up, I want to talk about kind of the most powerful app inside, well, in my opinion, the most powerful app inside Setapp, and that is CLEANMYMAC X. And yeah, they, the creators of Setapp, did create CLEANMYMAC. So CLEANMYMAC, it's what it does. It does clean your Mac, and let me just show you. It does a bunch of stuff. So you can open up, you can have protection, like malware protection. You can, let me just open CLEANMYMAC right over here so we can see all the details. So you can scan your computer, and it will clean up, do some protection, and it will enhance speed also. Also, you have this optimization, maintenance, uninstaller, updater, and you can take a look at your extensions. And you can also, yeah, this is so awesome. You can also manage your files. You can delete or kind of find your old files and large files, and then you can, of course, get rid of them. Also, you can shred, like permanently delete your files. So this is a really, really cool app to maintain your Mac. And yeah, as you already know, Xcode takes up a lot of space, and I'm using this app frequently, like on a weekly basis. Okay, so that's CLEANMYMAC X. Next up, it's CLEANSHOT X. Now, CLEANSHOT X is kind of a one-purpose app. It takes screenshots. Now, this is really awesome because I'm just opening it up and hitting Command-Shift-4 or Command-Shift-3, and you can take a screenshot of your whole screen or a part of your screen. And the cool part here is that it is going to give you a list of all your screenshots on the left of your screen now. Because of this layout of the YouTube video, you will not be able to see, so I'm not going to show you this, but this is really, really cool. Like, these are, as you can see, the screenshots. There you can see in the video how they are appearing. Of course, you can annotate, you can upload to their servers and share. This is really, really a cool, handy screenshot creator on your Mac. Of course, all of this with setup. So let's go back and take a look at the next one. And this is FLINTO. Now, I'm not using FLINTO that much, but when I do, it is a very, very powerful app. Basically, it is creating interactive designs for your apps. And that is it. You're not just the UI, but the navigation, as you can see right here on the video there. And yeah, it is a very, very versatile app. I'm using it on apps when I have to create a design or kind of a prototype or a mock-up for my apps that I'm building for clients. But yeah, it is a punch. So that was FLINTO. Now, next up, what if you just simply want to create some cool screenshots of your app? Well, not just a simple screenshot, but a mock-up screenshot. So for that is what Mockups Studio is for. You can just take a screenshot in your simulator, for example, and just add all of this inside the mock-up studio. And you can see we can have custom backgrounds, all of that good stuff. So it's a really, 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 really handy mock-up creator with any type of phone. Of course, we're interested in iPhones, but there are quite a lot here. Okay, so let's move forward and take a look at this really, really tiny but helpful app that is called OneSwitch. And that is a menu bar app, and it's right over here, as you can see. And what this does, it's enabling us to toggle some sort of features with just one switch. So hide desktop icons, dark mode. So let me just toggle that. Let's not allow it for now because maybe it will interfere with the recording, but we can also keep awake, do not disturb, night shift, and all of that. And all of that good stuff can be customized. So you have this at a click of a button. Okay, so that is one switch. It's controlling various macOS features with a click. And we are nearly getting to the finish. Here we have Presentify. Now, it says give better presentations. And let me go right over here. And you can see if you are using it, let me just go ahead and, for example, of course, you have these keyboard shortcuts also. But if I annotate the screen, I can just go ahead and add an arrow there. Really, really nice. Also, you have this toolbar that you can just have, let's say, a square right over here, or you can type out some text right over there. Really, really nice. And of course, then you can just simply remove those annotations. It's really, really handy if you are having a presentation. You can use this in your Zoom calls or to present your clients some stuff. Okay, so that was Presentify. I'm using this quite a lot in my Zoom meetings. Okay, and finally, a productivity app, and it is called Sessions. I'm pretty sure that you already heard of the Pomodoro technique, 25 minutes of clean, focused work, and then 10 or 5 minutes of break. That is how you should work throughout the day and do these Pomodoro sessions. Session is a Pomodoro timer with analytics. So it's really, really cool. So let me just show you this. Let me just show sessions. And this is how it looks like. And you can start a session. You have a lot of options there. You can grade your session. Let me just show you the actual, let's see here, personalization, general, and let's reset the onboarding. And there it is. So of course, this is a Pomodoro app. Let's click on next. You can take a rest and you can block distractions. like any type of apps or websites or Slack, you can set those up. So that's really, really nice to be on the flow on those Pomodoro sessions. And then you can create this kind of automizations. You can turn on automatically do not disturb, play some Apple Music playlist, as you can see right over here. So it's really, really fancy. And after you finish your Pomodoro session, then you can reflect on your work. Was I distracted, neutral, or focused? Okay, and also it has a calendar integration, so you know what you were working on. And yeah, basically that's it. You can set a reminder at a point in time, in let's say on the morning at 10 o'clock, to use session on a regular basis. Okay, so that is sessions, and you can take a look at it on the setup app. And how do you do that? Well, you can just Google it, or if you do want 1 month free, then you can go to rebeloper.com/tools, and right over here you just click on try setup. That will guide you to my link, where you will get 1 month, the first one, for free. So hope you enjoyed this list of my 10 must-have best apps on my Mac. And yeah, hope to see you join Setup as I did. I have been using Setup for more than a year now, and I cannot praise it enough. So those were the 10 apps I absolutely cannot live without on my Mac, and they are a part of Setup. Now, if you do want 1 month free, go ahead and check out the link in the description, where you can find my link, and they will know that I guided you there. So, if you do want to learn more Swift or Swift UI or these kind of tutorials on what's on my Mac, go ahead and hit that notification bell. And if you do actually like these videos, hit that like button. It helps a lot with the YouTube algorithm. So, go ahead and check Setup in the description. And if you do like these videos, go ahead and check out these two, because I talk a lot about Swift, of course, UIKit, and Swift UI in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.